Happy birthday, Gonzaga University. You are 125 years young. What better way to pay tribute to this auspicious event than to tell the story of how you got to this distinguished age? Here now is a whirlwind journey through Gonzaga history. In 1881, Father Joseph Cataldo purchases 320 acres of land along the Spokane River for $936. 6 years later, Gonzaga College officially opens its doors in the original college building to 19 male students and an all-Jesuit faculty. Tuition and board for a 10-month session? $250. By 1899, this Gonzaga College thing is really catching on. Room is so scarce, the construction of College Hall begins. Using over 1 million bricks, it's one of the biggest buildings in Spokane. It's the turn of the century, and what better way to celebrate than moving the original college building a whopping one square block? 1903 brings President Teddy Roosevelt to Spokane and a stop at Gonzaga College, where he's greeted with flowers and a poem of welcome. In 1906, typhoid fever hits campus, spread by the lack of water circulation in the pool in the basement of present-day College Hall, forcing an early closure of school. Snow days are way better. 1912 is a busy year with Gonzaga celebrating 25 years, becoming Gonzaga University and adding its prestigious law school. Gonzaga football gains national attention in 1922, prompting construction of a 12,000-seat football stadium where Crosby Student Center and Foley Library currently stand. 2 years later, a Gonzaga law student named Bing Crosby leaves Gonzaga and heads to Hollywood, while construction of Dismet Hall didn't begin until later that year. So Bing couldn't have pushed that legendary piano off its roof, as urban legend holds. In 1926, an overflowing Gonzaga separates into a high school and university, but they all turn out together when Babe Ruth visits campus. In December of 1941, the fourth floor of College Hall goes up in flames, burning the law library and several science labs and lecture halls. The world goes to war in the 1940s, and with so few students on campus, football ends at Gonzaga, never to begin again. The Zags join the war effort, welcoming 300 Navy cadets to train on campus, using a 28-event obstacle course erected on the quad, considered one of the toughest in the country, and designed by one of Gonzaga's own Jesuits, Father Arthur Dussault. In 1945, the SS Gonzaga Victory is commissioned. The university donates several books to the ship's library. With the end of the war, a new era begins in America and on campus as the first women attend Gonzaga, with 75 registering in the fall of 1948. Table manners across campus improve dramatically. In 1950, the Bulldogs gain national attention, becoming co-national collegiate boxing champions. In 1957, Gonzaga's most famous musical alum helps raise funds to build a Crosby Library, which would later become the Crosby Student Center. The 1960s is a big decade for Gonzaga. In 1961, Frank Burgess puts GU Hoops on the map, leading the nation in scoring. In 1963, the school purchases and renovates historic Bosarth Mansion. Gonzaga becomes a global presence, opening its Florence, Italy campus, guided by longtime program director Father Tony Villa. And a faculty hiring wave begins that continues through the 70s that solidifies Gonzaga's academic excellence for years to come. In 1965, Gonzaga honors the late President Kennedy, christening its new athletic facility the Kennedy Pavilion. The 60s rumble to a close as a little-known band, Led Zeppelin, comes to campus, earning Gonzaga a place in rock lore as the site of their earliest recorded concert. An ad for the show confuses them with a solo artist named Len Zeppelin. Oops! The 70s bring on board President Bernard Coughlin, whose savvy, together with trustee Harry Magnuson, helps keep Gonzaga's doors open. With the 80s comes John Stockton, averaging 20 points a game and shooting 57% from the field in his senior season before being drafted by the Utah Jazz. Stockton's success sparks another era as the Kennel Club begins its legendary reign as one of the most raucous cheering sections in all of college basketball. In 1989, Gonzaga's own Thomas S. Foley becomes America's 57th Speaker of the House. Through the last decade of the century and into the new millennium, driven by the ever-passionate President Robert Spitzer, Gonzaga grows as never before, with 20 new facilities and a near doubling of the student population. 1998 begins a string of top four appearances in the U.S. News & World Report Best Regional University Rankings that continues to this day. And Cinderella visits Gonzaga that same year as the men's basketball team appears in the NCAA Elite Eight. They haven't missed the tournament a single year since. In the new millennium, the first lay president, Dr. Thane McCullough, is appointed. The women's basketball team appears in the NCAA Elite Eight, with Courtney Vandersloot leading the way, and the GU debate team makes its first Final Four appearance. In 2012, Archbishop Desmond Tutu kicks off the 125th anniversary celebration as commencement speaker. What a fitting way to say happy birthday to Gonzaga University. Here's to another 125 more.